Hello, and welcome back to the 6th episode of the Lone Wolf campaign. In the previous episode, we successfully pushed the Germans all the way from Warsaw until the Pullman. And we were only about 50 kilometers away from the Berlin. So we already can see the end of the war coming. Let's see. The Hungarian have more than 50 factories, so they're probably counted as a major country. I think that's how it works. Let me check. So diplomacy, open country list, and major countries. Poland is still considered as a major country. That's weird. I think this list is incomplete, but basically, at least it's the way it was at the start when the game was just released. The rule was if you have more than 50 factories, and Hungary has more than 50 factories, I think. Yeah, because even if you take the least estimated amount, they have 51 factories. Then they're considered a major country in a war. So this war is not gonna end until both Germany and Hungary can capitulate, and if Japan is gonna join them, plus Japan. So let's continue exactly where we left off in the previous episode. Going towards Berlin. We have a major force incoming from the southern part, and currently at least just as three divisions just stationed here. I'm not thinking of an attack until these guys are gonna cross this river. And we're also taking this province, so I can move a single division like this and support my Berlin attacking force. And something happened that I probably should have expected, but I forgot about that. The Soviet Union declared war on Poland. The Polish have 4 or 5 divisions. That's clearly not enough to hold the line against the Soviets. That sucks. Okay. That means that the Soviets are gonna attack us through here, so we need to finish this war as quickly as possible now. What can I do? I cannot piss them out. What about the Germans? I cannot piss them out either. So, how would we hold this line against the Soviet Union? That's a good question. They're shifting their troops around. I can see at least 25 divisions leaving the front line, probably towards the Polish. How experienced are these troops? Yeah, they already got up to regular, which is good. Those guys are veterans only. Almost are veterans only. So we got veteran, seasoned, and some regular divisions. Maybe I can reassign this army to the Polish line. So I'll basically extend my defensive line. Okay, that's a forest. That's a plain. That's a bad territory. What about this? Forest. Okay, so here, three forests like this. Then go along this river. So that's 6, 9, 12, 13, 14, 15 provinces. Like that. And when the Polish are gonna lose, eventually we'll take Cracker from them. But that's in the future. So it's gonna be, and we have 15 divisions. Plus, we have, yeah, we can deploy a single green one. Let's start training one more division. And time to delete this line and draw a new one. Gonna go like this. So for this unit, we need to move around because Riga is gonna lose four divisions. We need to move a single division here. Polish want a non-aggression pact, I don't care about that. I'm not gonna attack them, but I'm not gonna promise that I'm not gonna attack them. And we need to finish this, so let's start rushing towards Berlin. We need to destroy the Germans, so... we'll need to do attacks everywhere. It's gonna stretch out our line, but I don't think the Germans are capable of defending anymore. Yeah, they're losing a lot of divisions, probably on the Western Front. I have only done a single encirclement on my side, so it's not definitely not the same to me, but I was just killing them in battle. Okay, I don't see Hungarian divisions just yet, but they're gonna be coming soon. Also, as for resources, let's see. Surplus. Okay, everything is fine. As for production, looks okay. There's. We're getting our artillery supplies. Continue pushing towards Berlin. Berlin is a target. Let's take this and do a support attack from two sides. Okay, the Soviets are now trying to push in into our weakened line, as we don't have as many divisions now defending it, but that's because we're sending our troops towards Poland. Okay, they're doing the attack. And this time it's not a 90% winning battle, but just this. Okay, we're losing this one. Let's see, how's everything else going? We can increase this one like this. And we're attacking the Berlin, finally. Port attack. Take the city. Continue going here. And you two can take the next points. Okay, we're missing some resources. And we got 3 military factories, so we have 2 more. Let's see, what do we need? I'd say let's add the new one. Gonna be at the bottom, just 4 more like this. And let's get 4 more like this. And now we need to buy steel from Sweden, because that's where we usually buy our steel from. Okay, this battle's going fine. Maybe I was a little bit too eager to pull the trigger over there, but I can move it divisions from here instead, because this one has 3 divisions and we can spare one. Yeah, the Polish are losing land really fast. We took the balloon. And the Germans are... oh, 60% capitulated, so... now... what I hope is gonna happen is that... we'll be able to close the border with allies, do a few encirclements here, and then we can send our army towards Munich and Vienna, which is a new German capital. You do attack here, you do support it, you push in, you support this, and you do support attack like this. Aim for one of you guys. Okay, the Soviets don't have a lot of troops on our borders because they transferred almost everyone towards this Polish line. So this is gonna give us some free time so we can rearrange our troops a little bit. Oh yeah. I forgot to do that. I did this. And we can add even 2 more divisions. Training. Also, I'm gonna release them as green divisions from now on. Okay, they're moving in, so I'll need some units there. You can help the stack. can do this. So 9% and then we can deploy a new green division. Alright. We almost met meeting the allies finally. We're connecting the Western Front with the Eastern Front. Almost like in real life, but instead of the Soviets, it's Lithuanian troops. We're gonna join them. Now, let's continue pushing the Germans everywhere we can. You can do that. Those guys. Okay, I think it's time to cut off the this division's in the north. And we can start pushing them in. So nice of Germans. They send us to strategically redeploy even more divisions so we can destroy even more in this encirclement. I don't have to. I have to constantly look at the Polish front because now the Soviets have a much bigger front line with us. Okay, the Soviets are not successful in their attacks. And we have new free military factories. We have one more. Let's see, what do we need the most now? I'd say let's start increasing our weapons production by 4 more factories. Also, you probably saw that I'm doing a weird way of using these lines. Basically, I'm only using a divisible of 4. And that's helpful, at least I think it's helpful, because when you're trading with someone, we can stop buying this because we've got more steel from Germans. When you're trading with someone, you're trading for 8 resources every time. So, if you do your factories and make sure that they're always divisible by 4, you're not wasting resources which you're buying from someone else. And that's basically my reasoning behind using my factories like this. Also, something that I forgot to do, but I need to start increasing my fortifications, because we are gonna get attacked a little bit more. Okay, you go here and you go here. Well, we're having a single unsuccessful attack. I'll just stop this because I don't want to waste too many men. We can add additional. And I think it's finally time to add the artillery. I know I still don't have enough, but at least I'll get some firepower to fight against the Soviets. Some additional firepower. Okay, I don't need a front line against the Allies, so everyone who was assigned to that one, they're gonna get reassigned like this. Do we need this? Let me see the research. Not yet. I'll take that one after I finish researching the 94 equipment, so I can get a minus 100% for 1944 equipment instantly. And so because this one gives a 100% reduction for the time penalty due to ahead of time. So I want to use that as much as possible, and in the current case it's I'll have to wait for this technology first. Okay, how close the Germans are to capitulating? 63%. And how much how much do I have? I'm getting 1,080, so almost 1,200 points. Let's see how many points the French got. The French got almost the same. They just got more points because they're losing more men than me. And they get a little bit less free occupation, but the Netherlands should have a lot of points for occupation. Oh no, only 258. And same for Belgium. Okay, we're getting attacked in our new Polish front line. We finished researching concentrated industries. So it's time to researching fighters. Our first fighter technology. Then we'll instantly get the second one. Okay, I think it's time to shift one more division down. Just along this whole line. Okay, who the hell sent troops away from this point? I hate AI when they do that, because those two divisions were there. Can we deploy anyone? No, four more percent. So okay, we've got these two divisions not assigned anywhere. You're gonna go to the north and finish this encirclement. I got some units assigned to this front line. It's not needed because I'm not at war with allies just yet. So let's start pushing in. Yay! We're gonna do a support attack from this side. Okay, we finished the assembly line. Technology. Gonna give us 20% efficiency cavalry. And we can start researching. What else do we have? Let's go for the next artillery. So advanced artillery. This attack is not going well. I can still stop that. Okay, move there because we need help. Go there, that's a corner province. It's gonna be hard to defend, even though it has two forts. Oh, accidentally turned on the knight camp, the knight circle, which is awful. It looks cool when you just play the game for the first few hours, but then it just gets annoying because if you turn it on, the map changes every 24 hours, and that's not cool. It just hurts your eyes more than it helps. Okay, let's retreat from here because the Germans are finally organizing a counterattack. Board attack hit. You do an actual attack. Let's see. Okay, we can take this province. Hopefully we will be reached before allies. There's supposed to be 5 divisions. I think I just moved 2 divisions which were assigned to that line to the south instead. The Poland are really close to getting annexed by the Soviets. Oh no, they still have they still have majority of their points because that's in Krakow. Which will try to take back from the Soviets as soon as they will get it, because that's Krakow has 2 urban provinces and they're really good at defending, and they're also across the river. Okay, you're gonna help there. How's our fort construction going? Okay. That says this one, it's almost finished. Okay, now we have 2 units at there, which we can assign to this line. And let's delete it. We're holding our Soviet borders just fine for now. Right now I'm just shooting my troops around because I need to hold this province, and it's kind of a trace crit now. How many men did the Soviets lose so far? Almost 3 million. And the Germans are soon going to reach 2 million. Okay, those guys are out of organization, they're out of equipment, and we can start the attack now. And again, keep creating this line with the allies, which I have to delete every single time. Also, I think it's time to change up the plan to take in the rest of Germany. The Germans are 63% towards capitulations. That didn't increase by a lot since the last time I checked. Okay. Let's take the field hospitals. Okay, let's retreat with these two divisions, and they're gonna go there towards western part of Krakow. Or maybe even we can come back and fight. Okay, the Soviets are dangerously close to Krakow. Let's decrease this line so we can move a single division like this, and we'll just move one by one. You go there. You go there. Retreat. Let's see. Okay, we can deploy two divisions. Oh no, I forgot. I need to change that deployment point to, I think, in Lodz. Yeah. That feels like a good point. You guys are gonna strategically redeploy to this point. One to this and second to that one. Okay, now we have a single division. Touch to this, go here, delete this line. Let's go to Rostock, and then we'll just leave this line to the allies. I think they should be more than capable of defending and just finishing them off in Denmark. Okay, the Soviets are doing an attack here. Four divisions that we need to apprehend. Well, we still have time, and while we're doing this, let's move a single division like this. You are going. Okay, and you go here instead. And the Polish are about to lose their last city. Oh, come on. Stop moving. I didn't want to lose this fort. I know it's an extra province which keeps four units, but it also makes them try to attack it. It has a really good defense because it has two forts, plus a river for this three provinces, which just makes them waste their units on it. We don't need the national focus. And we're waiting for these guys. Now we can just assign them there. Delete this line. I trust the allies to finish that off. And I'll strategically redeploy so everyone. So they won't waste too much time. And after that, I'll do a final attack on the Germans. And hopefully take their final two cities. Or maybe just one city. I'll go for Vienna while the Allies will go for Munich. Okay, we're holding off the Soviet attacks, but now there are gonna be a lot more Soviets attacking. So I feel like this line is about to get broken, yeah. And we're getting attacked here by how many? Four divisions. Do you have anyone else to deploy? Yes. Okay, you're gonna get deployed. Right here. Go to this point. The second division, is gonna get deployed here. And you arrive in 2 days, 3 days. Yeah, 2 days, 23 hours, so 3 days roughly. And also I think it's time to change the general, because we need the most experienced one defending Poland. That's probably where they're gonna do the hardest attack, as they just finished up taking the Polish land. And let's switch the least experienced one here. The allies keep asking. Oh no, come on! You had one job. You had one job to keep the Germans from coming, for God's sake. So this means I need to take two divisions. Go there. Strategically redeploy them here, and they just make it like this. And let's continue the attacks on the Vienna. Next target, Vienna. Going through this month is gonna be hard, but should not be possible for our decent troops. Okay, the Soviets didn't break our line. That's good. Okay, we have 0 men, so these two divisions are going to be the last two which are going to get trained. Oh, I left Prague empty. We can take that. Port attack from this side. Where are you going? Why are you going there? And again, assign everyone to this line. Delete this one. Hey, the next milestone! 3 million Soviet dead troops, and we almost reached the 2 million one for the Germans. Support attack Prague. They sent 4 divisions here, but our divisions should be more than capable of taking it from them. Let's take this. Support attack from 4 sides. Stop this attack, that's a mountain. So let's stop this attack. They seem to reinforce it really hard. Okay, let's send help. What about Soviet borders? So, Soviet borders. Do you have anyone to deploy? Almost. Okay, what's the Soviet next one? They're going for this. I'm hoping that they will go for war with Germany or war with Japan, because otherwise they're at war with only me and whatever is left of Polish. Wow, Poland is still holding crack. I'm impressed. Okay, time to deploy this division. Yep, right here. And they're gonna go and help with its defense. Oh, wrong button. Okay, yeah, that's what I was. Forgot about them. Go here like this. You're gonna go here, and then they will take this back. Oh, come on. That's annoying. Oh, change of plans. Yeah, see they. port. This one. Oh no. Okay, they're attacking this now. Okay, let's do this and decrease the line by one province for now. Those guys are off, really. Get deployed. Wait a second, where are you going? Why are you going there? How's this going? That's fine. Yeah, they're quickly dying there. You can go continue the attack. Yeah, oh yeah, we lost some factories. This factories. Oh, and they're attacking. Which one is moving north? You go there. Okay, you're gonna arrive there. You just move, and you move. Okay. Finally, we finished up with this threat. This means that I can assign this division here now. And you're gonna get strategically redeployed to this point. Let's see who's faster. French or our division? Ah, they won. Oh well. Okay, you can go to this line. Now we have 48 divisions fighting against the Soviets. And let's increase it like this. Okay, let's not increase it like this until that division is gonna arrive there. Diplomats from Germany and the Soviet Union concluded what observers are describing as a historic agreement today, with signing of Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact. Yeah. I'm sure that's not gonna go wrong at all. Because they just did that 3 years later than they should have done that. In the game it's supposed to claims them on all these territories, but they already took most of it, so it doesn't matter. So the only new claims that they will get from this pact is Bessarabia and Bukovina from Romania, so they get these two claims. And they got a claim on Kariala and Sawa, and I believe this one, yeah, that's Sama. Time to start taking the Krakow from the Soviets. Where are you going? Stop doing that. Okay, the next one is going to be Prince of Terror that we haven't done last time. That should decrease the resistance. We're losing some factories to them. We're slowly making our forts. I think this territory will belong to us. Yes, it did. So let's do that. Where are you going? Yeah, that's fine. But I think strategic redeployment is going to be better than that. Yeah, and our push towards Vienna is halted because now the Germans are kind of focusing on us. As you can see, in some territories they have up to 9 divisions, and my Marines won't be able to push through that, that's for sure. And also, they have a healthy Hungarian divisions helping them, so which have 100% organization or strength. As you can see, here, here, and here, so about 10 divisions. Oh no, even more, 24. Yeah, I can see 24 infantry divisions from Hungary. And I think this will be it for this episode. Will we be able to push the Soviets back? And will the Germany capitulate? We'll see that in the next episode.